is up, ladies and gentlemen. It's your boy, Rome.
I'm TK.
And this is the 25th episode of Gospel Ride Along. Now, y'all, this is what's going on. This series of Gospel Ride Along is going to focus on our back to school bash. We're going to be featuring some college students, high school students, teachers, principals, anybody who works in the school district. They will be featured from now until August when we go back to school. So, starting us off, I'm here with my brother, TK Ketter. Would you like to tell them a little bit about yourself out there?
My name is Tarrence Ketter. They call me TK. My favorite color, green. I run track for Hartsville High. I just recently committed to North Greenville University. I've been majoring in sports management.
Committed. North Greenville University. So if you're watching this video and you are attending North Greenville University, go ahead and drop the likes. Drop the comments. Go ahead and show this episode some love because you have a freshman coming in, y'all. But y'all, we ain't gonna hold y'all too long. We're gonna go ahead and get this video started. As always, we do have our mask. We do have our Lysol, you know, to spray down for the bacterialize. And we have our hand sanitizer. So I'm gonna go ahead and just say, if you're watching this, like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe to the channel. Because if you're not subscribed to Rome's World, then what planet are you from? Now let's go ahead and get into this. It's only right that we go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Father God, Lord, I just want to thank you, God, for allowing us to be here for another episode, Father God. And Father God, I want to thank you for allowing us to be able to make this series about our youth, because the youth are in need of some real good motivation from kids their age, young adults their age. And I think that this series is really going to take off. But Father God, I want to put all the glory in your name. Father God, I pray that you let me and Tarrence decrease as you increase within us so that we may touch somebody out here today, Father God. Lord, I pray that we have safe travels on the highways and the byways. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's go ahead and get this episode started, because I was listening to your list a little bit before we started, and I think you got what they call some bangers on this list tonight. So let's see what we got up first. Echo by Taryn Wells featuring Elevation Worship. This one of my jams right here.
Night has fallen, and fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost, and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is falling on
All right, now, you got to love some tan whales. Now, TK, would you tell the audience out there what was the reason for this being one of your songs?
All right, so I go to One Church of Hartsville. Shout out to them. And they introduced me to the song when I used to dance for the, well, I still do when I dance for the kids. And it's one of my favorite songs. It gets you in a good mood. And the stuff that it be saying, it actually means a lot when it says your love won't let, when his love won't let go. So basically, when you feeling down yourself, when you feeling down and out, just know you got his love and you'll be good in life.
Because we live in a world today when love is the biggest problem. Love is the biggest issue for a lot of things when it comes to the world that we live in today. There's a lot of people out there in the world who feel like they don't have love, or love is toxic for them, or love is too good to be true for them. But we're here to tell y'all today that there's only one love that really matters in this world, and that's the love of Jesus Christ, the love of God, because God has sacrificed his only son to die on the cross for our sins, so that we may have everlasting life. And I'ma tell y'all, that's true love. Because see, I don't have kids, but I'ma tell y'all right now, as a parent, you would do anything you can to protect your child's life, not give it up for something else. And for God to do that, that's unconditional love. That's love that cannot be matched. You can never match God's love. Because if I know there's somebody who's going to love you through the thick and thin no matter what, that's God. Our grandma used to always look at sinners. There's only one man that she had faith in and got trust in, and that's Jesus, because he's never going to leave you and never forsake you. Out there, we have to keep a mindset that God is more than what the world, and listen to what I said, the world tries to tell us what he is. Our God is not one-dimensional. He could take one-dimensional problems and turn them into three, four-dimensional blessings. Come on now, somebody. I know somebody out there heard that one. Comment down below. I want everybody to comment down below right now. Our God is not one-dimensional. Comment that in the comment section for me. So TK, with you, like you said, you go to one church and everything. How does the atmosphere, and I'm going to ask you this question because this is a topic that we don't talk about a lot. With you being an African American, how does you going to a predominantly white church affect you and your religion and your faith with God?
Well, I feel like that church maybe get closer with God. They basically like a second family. Another big happy family I can go to on every Sunday and every Wednesday, and any other time they have a church event.
Mm-hmm. That's nice. That's real nice. You see, I brought that question up because I want to talk about this topic just a little bit as well while we're on the subject. Church is church, ladies and gentlemen. Church is church. Don't classify church. When somebody asks you what church do you go to, you don't have to say, I go to a black church, I go to a white church. You go to church. God does not put limitations on faith. He does not put limitations on how you should worship, how you should praise. Everybody worships and prays in their own way. And you should never let anybody conduct, key word, you should never let anybody conduct how you worship and praise your God. You don't have to let anybody tell you, oh, because you're black or you're white, that you can only limitate yourself to the dominations of your church, No, if the word is reaching you, if God is speaking to you, if you feel like, as he said, it is a close-knit family, then that's where God wants you to be in that season. Because now, don't get me wrong, everybody does not stay in the same area for long. God is not stagnant. God does not just stay in one area. He goes everywhere. And wherever he goes, he's going to take you with him. So he wants you to know that in this season where you're at right now, It may be good, but I have something better for you. You just have to trust God and trust in the process, because his love is holding on and it won't let go. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Come on now. Come on now, somebody out there. But yeah, y'all, we ain't gonna keep y'all too long. We're not gonna keep y'all too long, because we're gonna go ahead and get into TK's next song. And I gotta say, this song right here, it's so simple. It's real simple, because I listened to him sing it yesterday, last night, when he was on the game with his boys. And this song is just something so simple.
Daddy, who is
it's called
nearly 70 years old.
God
is seems good. To feel like some of today's gospel music has lost its way. You see, my daddy's from Kershaw, South Carolina, raised in Bright Light Baptist Church and Ebenezer Baptist Church. My daddy believes that when you hear gospel, it ought to sound like gospel. So my sister told me that she was making a gospel record. I wanted to make sure that it was something on there for my daddy. So daddy, we're gonna take it back.
All right now, TK. All right now. Come on now.
stand made away. Then you put food on my table, and he put shoes on my feet, so he could guide my every footstep. Jesus saved my soul. Then he brought me out of darkness. God is good.
All you got to say out there, y'all, just say it with us.
God is good. God is good.
Come on now, y'all. Come on now, y'all. I don't know about y'all, but like y'all don't understand, it don't get no simpler than that. God is good. God is good yesterday, God is good today, and God will continue to be good forever. You see, sometimes we get in the concept of where we don't know what to say when God has done things for us. We think we gotta go to God and give God this big, big prayer. And although he deserves it, but sometimes God just wants you to just say, God is good. Sometimes that's all he wants you to say. You know, when somebody asks you how you got or what you got, you ain't got to give no whole background sad story. All you got to do is tell them, God is good. When somebody looks at you and say, well, normally, if you would have said that to me a long time ago, I would have said this. But you know why I didn't? Because God is good. TK, would you like to tell them out there how good God is?
He's very good.
How good?
So good.
So good. Not one, two, three, four, but five good. Not two good, but three, four, five, six, seven good. Eight, nine, 10, 11 good. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. You see, you got to thank God for the little things in life. You start off by thanking God. You see, everybody love to say, well, my alarm clock woke me up this morning. Your alarm clock ain't woke you up this morning. Because if your alarm clock woke you up this morning, how come you still sleep through some of them other alarms that you done set? that because God woke you up this morning. And that's good. That's a good God. That's because God's saying there's so much more on this earth that I still want you to do. There's so much more on this earth that you have to accomplish in my name before I end up calling you home to me. And see, y'all don't understand. God is, like, God is good, y'all. God is good.
That song was a soul hitter. That's the new word of the day.
Soul, that's a what? That's a soul hitter.
New word of the day, soul hitter.
Something y'all hit heard
your,
it.
Something hit your soul in a positive, good way, call it a soul hitter.
That's a soul hitter.
Trade you know what?
You know, that might be the title of this episode.
Soul hitter.
Soul hitter. Because these are some soul hitters you got. These are some serious soul hitters you got, TK. But we ain't gonna keep it too long, because I'm gonna go ahead and get to your next song. Waymaker. We're gonna go ahead and get to your next song. Now, this is one of those songs right here where you just take personal time to talk with God. This is your worship time to just thank God for being who He is and thank Him for what He's done. And you have to also remember to thank God for the things that He is still continuing to do and the things that He's about to do for you in your life. Just listen to the words. Listen to what He says.
You are here, moving in my midst. I worship You. I worship You. You are here, working in this place. I worship You. I worship You. you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working.
Take this time to worship. Just take this time to just praise and worship God. Now see y'all, God is the way maker, the miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Just like the song said, and this is my favorite part of the song, when he says, even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You see, that's because, see, God is always preparing the way for us. As long as there's breath in your body, God is continuing to guide your every footsteps. God is continuing to work, because no matter what, we go through some things in life that are hard for us to get through. But you see, even though bad things happen to us at times, if in the end, if we keep our faith and trust in God and let Him continue to work, God is going to make everything work out for our good. Everything works out for our good in due time. You know, I talk about this all the time on the Gospel Ride Alone. We all have goals. We all have dreams. We all have a plan. And we always say we want to do this by a certain age, or I want to reach this by a certain point in my life. But when we get to that point and we're still in the same spot, we look at God and question God and say, why? That's because God say, that's not the plan that I have for you right now. I'm a firm believer that everybody is going to reach their destiny and their purpose and their point in life where things take off of them in a positive way. But it's up to us just how quickly we're going to get there. You see, we talked about on the last episode when God is our GPS. And sometimes we go down the straight and narrow path, but we get tired. We get bored. We get tired of looking at the trees. We get tired of looking at the sky and not seeing nothing else but just far land, far land. We on a straight road and there's no twists and turns. There's no uphills. There's no downhills. It's just a straight road. So you know what we do? We get tired of waiting on God. So we make our own path and we go left or we go right. But the GPS never said turn right. The GPS never said turn left. But one thing about a GPS, just like God, when we get off path, what that GPS gonna say? Recalculate it. And it's gonna get you back on the same straight and narrow path that you was on before you decide to make your own shortcut. You see, sometimes we are in a position in our lives because God knows that what we want ain't what we need. And some of us don't understand that concept. There's a difference between want and need. If you go for what you need, you will get what you want because God gives us what we need and not what we want. Because sometimes we may want something, but it ain't good for us. And God sees that. For example, since we're talking about the youth, and this is a youth episode, this is the youth series, and we're going to start getting into principles and stuff like that. Like Tarrence, my brother Tarrence right here, he's going to college. And there's some things that, as a college student, you're going to have to grasp, and you hate that you have to grab certain things in certain ways. You see, as you graduate, some of y'all have already graduated and are getting ready to graduate, depending on where you are and where you live. But as a graduate of a high school, you are now moving on to a different level in life. Some friends that you started out with are not going to be on that same level. But that doesn't mean that they're not still going to be your friends. It's just the only way you can decipher the difference between friendships in college and high school is you have to understand that everybody's progression is not the same as your progression. Everybody has to get that concept. Just because one friend made it out doesn't mean you're not going to. It's just not your time right now. But see, some of us, we watch our friends grow and do better things for themselves. But because it's not happening for us, we get upset, we get jealous. That friend that we used to have is not our friend. So sometimes God is going to separate us. You wonder why you ever had a close friend and all of a sudden they stopped talking to you, they stopped hanging around you. That wasn't for no reason. That was God removing them because God sees where you are about to go and they're not ready to handle your elevation. They're not ready to move on while you're moving on. God heard and saw things that you didn't hear and see. So he removed them from your life. Come on now, somebody. I know somebody out there heard that message. You got a thing? You got something to say on that, TK?
I got to say one thing. When you want to get to the top, you got to lead some people. You want to do positive things, do good things in life. Whoever holding you back, you got to let them go and do good for yourself.
And that's a true statement. And the key word, you have to do good for yourself. And that starts with simple things. You can't do good for somebody else if you can't do good for yourself first. Because your reflection of yourself is going to carry to other people. It's going to carry to other people. When you walk around, you don't want people to see you. You want people to see God in you so they can understand, okay, God is this, God is that. God is, like I said, God is not one-dimensional. God is more than just one-dimensional. And the quicker that we understand that as people, we can be able to have heaven on earth. Now, y'all, I done talked enough. I ain't gonna keep talking too long because I'm over here supposed to be controlling the music. I'm over here giving y'all the good word. I'm trying to stay on track. I'm trying to stay on track. Y'all, come on now. So we're gonna go ahead and get into the next song. Reckless Love.
Come on.
basically another way maker. Just you get to sit back and listen and just thank God for what he has done for you. And I want to take a little flashback when we all sung God is Good. Mm-hmm. That song remind me of, like, you know, the 12 Days of Christmas song.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You just go through a list. This song is basically a list of things God can do for you, how he makes a way and stuff like that.
Because, see, the whole time we was riding, I was thinking that same thing. I said, this is like the 12 days of Christmas my true love gave to me. And it just naming all the wonderful things that God has done. And, you know, as a matter of fact, we're going to put that in the comments down below. Go ahead and comment down below some things that you're thankful for right now. Go ahead and comment some things that God has done for you in your life. Because you don't understand, when you acknowledge the things that God has done for you in your life, he's going to acknowledge some things that he's getting ready to do deeper for you in your life. But y'all, like I said, we still got one more song left. So I'm going to go ahead and play it. Can I go ahead and get to the last song? The last song? And Tarrence, you're taking me back. Because I remember this song right here. I remember this song. You're taking me way back with this song. I probably was like 5, 6, or 7 when this song came out. And this is a banger to me. This right here is a banger to me. This is one of those good church songs right here. This right here was doing when Kirk Franklin started popping and Mary Mary came out strong. So I got to get this song. I got to play this song. It's only right. Go ahead and get to it. I know y'all feeling, I see y'all out there. I gotta get myself together, cause I got some place to go. And I'm praying when I get there, I see everyone I know. I wanna go to heaven, I wanna go to heaven. I wanna go to heaven, I wanna go to heaven. Come on now.
Walking down the street that's golden, angels singing perfect way.
y'all out there, you wanna go? Do you wanna go? Come on now, y'all.
All right, I gotta explain this song.
Go ahead, Tarrence. Tell them about it.
All right, so obviously the song is about getting to heaven, and that's where they wanna go. But I got that meaning to it too. But there's a alternate interpretation I like. When it says I gotta get my things together because I got some place to go, that can mean anything. It can be stuff within yourself, like going through stuff. You gotta get your stuff, you gotta get yourself together, get your things together so you can probably go to a place where you want to be. Like, say I want to make the Olympics, get my things together so I go to the Olympics. Basically a goal in your life. So yeah, that's my alternate interpretation of that song, one of them.
Well, that's nice. That's real nice. And you write about that song. That song gives off so much more than a deeper meaning, because you can take the song and make it how you want to make it. Because, you know, everybody's end goal is to make it to heaven one day and see everybody you know. Because trust me, I know I don't want to be left behind. You know, all the people that I have memories with here on earth, I want to be able to share those same memories in a heavenly place where the streets are made with gold in our own mansions that God has prepared. And I don't want to miss it. When they do that final roll call, Lord knows I don't want to be left out. I don't want to be one of the ones wishing I would have got my stuff together today, when I could have been had my stuff together. And like the song says, it gets hard sometimes. You know, we not gonna do everything perfect all the time. And we shouldn't let nobody hold us to that standard. All you have to know is you give God your heart and you just keep trying. And you just keep pushing for greatness. God sees all of your hard work. He sees your efforts, and he's not gonna leave you, and he's not gonna forsake you. But yeah, y'all.
I wanna give a shout out.
Go ahead, talk to him.
They talked to me earlier in the day. I've been with them all day. I wanna shout out Minerva Ketter, my grandma, and Georgia Walters, my aunt. They basically the OGs, basically. The originals in my life. Ever since I came out the womb, they always been there. Now 18 years later, they still there, and I don't know what I'll do without them. I'm gonna miss them when August 14th hit. Love.
Yes, Lord. Boy. And we still got some riding to do. So while we got some more time, I think I'll play one of my selection. You know, I don't know how big you are on some quartet music, Tim, but I'm about to put you on to some quartet. I'm about to put you on to some Tim Rogers and the Fellas. Send off song, y'all. church. Ah, yeah.
Ain't no turning back. Not now, church.
Ain't no turning back. Ain't no turning back. Not now, ain't no turning back.
Well, y'all, we have reached that mark. And I think it's only right if we go ahead and end with the closing prayer. Let me get where I can go ahead, y'all. Dear Father God, Lord, I just want to say thank you for allowing me to share this episode with my brother TK. Thank you, God, for allowing him to come and give his words of wisdom to reach kids and people of his age and his generation so they can see that you don't have to be an older generational person to understand the words of God. But Father God, while we're sitting here praying, I pray, Father God, that you bless him as he continues to further his education, as he continues to do things in this world. I pray, Father God, that you continue to touch him and lay your hands on him, because people fail to realize when you start doing good things, the devil will show up and try to take you off path. Father God, I pray that you just encourage him to stay grounded in his faith so that he can accomplish everything that you set out for him to accomplish. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And Terrence, I would like to say this as well, man. Watching you grow up all these years, doing the things that you do is amazing. To be able to watch you grow up is, like I said, it's amazing. I have no words to describe how proud I am of the things that you have accomplished, the things that you are going to accomplish. I cannot express how much I am proud of you, because people just don't know that when I have more siblings, y'all, people just don't know that when you have siblings, you, especially if you are an older sibling, you're not just a sibling. Sometimes you have to be a parent sometimes, because they look up to you as well, and you are the closest person to them in a household, no matter how separated or where, no matter your family situation. Family is important. That's why I'm going to say right now that we just keep our heads held high. And Terrence, I just want to say I love you. When August 14th come, y'all just don't know that that's going to be one of the hardest things that I have to do so far, is seeing my brother go off to college, whom I lived with all my life. I was his longtime roommate, y'all. For 18 years, I was his roommate. 18 years I've been his roommate, and now I got to let him go and be with somebody else for 4 years. So y'all to understand, it is a huge accomplishment. I'm proud of my brother Tarrence, and I just want to say God bless you, and I just hope that you continue, and I pray that no matter what, you know, if you need anything, even though you're 18 and you need some guidance, my bro, call me on anything. I don't care where you at. Greenville, that's 3 hours away. I don't care if you call me in the middle of the night. I would get up at 4 o'clock in the morning on the first interstate trip to Greenville if you need me for anything. And that is the heartfelt truth. I love you, and keep doing what you're doing. Well, y'all, it's that time. I'm Jerome.
I'm TK.
And this has been Gospel Ride Along.